Continuation of the previous video, alliteration. We saw what is alliteration. Now, we will see what is rhyme. Rhyme is the repetition of syllables typically at the end of the verse line. Rhymed words conventionally share all sounds following the word's last stressed syllable. Usually, children, the rhyming word will come in the end of the line. Yes? So, rhyme is one of the first poetic devices that we become familiar with, but it can be a tricky poetic device to work with. Yes? Yes. Types of rhyme include, there are three types of rhyme, children. First is full rhyme. Full rhyme means cat, hat, dog, log. Yes, while reading itself you can understand that it's a rhyming word. Half or para rhyme. What do you mean by half or para rhyme? Done, one. Shade, afraid. So these are also a rhyming word, but it is half rhyming word and not full rhyming word. Internal rhyme. A rhyme involving a word in the middle of the line and another at the end or in the middle of the next. For example, it matters not how straight the gate. So, the rhyme involving a word in the middle of the line. What is the rhyme in the middle of the line? Straight. And another at the end of the line. What is the end of the line? See the end of the line. That is gate. Yes. So straight and gate is not full rhyme, but it is a para rhyme. Yes. Understood? Rhyme scheme. Rhyme scheme is a pattern of rhyme that comes at the end of each verse or line in poetry. In another words, it is the structure of end words of verses or line that a poet needs to create when writing a poem. Example, in the poem Invictus, ABAB rhyme scheme is used and this pattern continues till the end. Out of the night that covers me. So, M-E, me. The line ends with me. So, I'll mark it as A. The letter A. Next. Black as the pit from pole to pole. Now, I'll mark it as B. Because me and pole is not a rhyming word, so I'll mark it as B. I thank whatever gods may be. So, what should I mark here? A. Because me and B is half para rhyming word. Half or para rhyming word. So, I mark it as A. Next, for my unconquerable soul. Pole and soul is a full rhyming word. So what will I mark here as? B. Again, I'll mark it as B. Now next, in the fell clutch of circumstances. So this doesn't go with any of the above words, circumstances. So I bring a new letter and mark it as C. Okay, now next, I have not winced nor cried aloud. So again, I bring a new letter and mark it as D. Yes, now next, under the burgeonings of chance, circumstances and chance is a half or para rhyming word. So I mark it as C again. Okay, now next. My head is bloody but unbowed. So, allowed and unbowed is a rhyming word. It's a full rhyming word. So, I'll be marking it as D. So, this is the pattern. This is how the rhyming scheme works. Okay? And remember, children, it is not necessary for a poem to have a rhyming scheme. It can be of free verse also. Yes, like for example, you can take merchant. It doesn't have a proper rhyming scheme. Yes, it is a free verse poem. Okay? So the rhyming scheme here in this poem is A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, which is known as alternate rhyme. Okay?